the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy.
Lord of mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ of mercy.
Christ of mercy.
Plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who led Saint Josephine Makita from abject slavery to the dignity of being your daughter and a bride of Christ, grant, we pray, that by her example we may show constant love for the Lord Jesus crucified, remaining steadfast in charity and prompt to show compassion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the beginning of the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters, to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the fourth day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, you are great indeed. You are clothed with majesty and glory, robed in light as with a cloak.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
You fixed the earth upon its foundation, not to be moved forever. With the ocean as with a garment you covered it. Above the mountains the water stood.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
You send forth springs into the watercourses that wind among the mountains. Beside them the birds of heaven dwell. From among the branches they send forth their song.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Alleluia.
May the Lord be glad in his works. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Jesus preached the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
After making the crossing to the other side of the sea, Jesus and his disciples came to land at Gennesareth and tied up there. As they were leaving the boat, people immediately recognized him. They scurried about the surrounding country and began to bring in the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. Whatever villages or towns or countryside he entered, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might touch only the tassel of his cloak, and as many as touched it were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And dear friends, today's Gospel is really a very, very brief summary of the healing activity of Jesus. Of course, this physical healing of persons is an anticipation of the more fuller healing of all of creation, which really is that full work of salvation for which Jesus came. Our first reading today, much more lengthy in comparison to the Gospel, is really the beginning of the creation story from the very, very start of the book of Genesis, the very beginning of the Bible itself. It's the creation, the account of the first 4 days. Tomorrow's first reading will be the remainder of creation from the first of the two creation stories in the book of Genesis. If you've ever been struck by the beauty of a sunrise or a sunset, or the wonderful sound of the birds punctuating the silence of a morning, or even perhaps the mysterious beauty of our landscape covered by fog as it was today. Ever been struck by that, you're forced to reflect on where it came from, who made it all, the Creator. Today's saint, Saint Josephine Bakita, is quoted as saying, "Seeing the sun, the moon, and the stars, I said to myself, who could be the master of these beautiful things? And I felt a great desire to see him, to know him, and to pay homage to him." Saint Josephine Bakita is a saint whose life is a combination of great pain and suffering, and also in the end, redemption. She is quite an example. I want to share with you a small bit of her biography as recorded for us in one of our popular daily missals. It says, Saint Josephine Bakita, she's an emancipated slave and a nun. Her dates are 1869 to 1947. At the age of 9, Bakita was kidnapped from her village in southern Sudan and sold into slavery. Over a period of years, she was sold from one set of masters to another, experiencing brutality in many forms. Eventually, she wound up with an Italian family who brought her back to Italy to work as a servant and nursemaid to their baby. When this child was old enough to be sent to a boarding school run by the Daughters of Charity, Bakita accompanied her. It was that then that she first heard the Gospel, and she divined God's will Upon learning of her mistress's plan to return to Sudan, Vaquita expressed her intention to remain. Unable to change Vaquita's mind, the Signora sued in court for the return of her property. Only then did Vaquita discover what no one had bothered to inform her, that slavery was illegal in Italy. She had been free all along. By this time, Vaquita had heard a voice urging her to consecrate herself to God. Baptized with the name Josephine Vaquita, she was accepted into the novitiate of the congregation that had sheltered her. She lived to the age of 78, mostly engaged in simple tasks, cooking, sewing, serving as a doorkeeper. No work was unimportant when done for the Master, which was her favorite name for God. She was famous for her quiet faith and care, and the care she brought to the assignments given her, both big and small. She died on the 8th of February, 1947, was canonized in the year 2000, becoming the first native saint of Sudan. Pope John Paul II himself took her relics back to Sudan. "Seeing the sun and moon," she says, "and the stars, I said to myself, who could be the master of these beautiful things? And I felt a great desire to see him, to know him, to pay him homage. A wonderful example for us who still enjoy the benefits of that wonderful creation." And so, observing her example and celebrating her feast today, we say, as is our custom, Saint Josephine Vaquita, pray for us. Let us pray. We put our needs before the Lord this day. We ask the Lord to instill in our hearts a deep sense of not only the beauty of creation, but our stewardship of creation, our respect for it, and our need to care for it, that we may have a true sense of preserving the creation, which is ours, our entire ecology. This we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Francis, our Pope, that he may continually lead us in the ways of Christ the Good Shepherd. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are unemployed at this time, that they not lose hope. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are ill, especially those who are infected with the COVID-19 virus. For this, for them and their healing and their restoration to good health, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Once again, we ask that you place before the Lord whatever needs you find most burdensome to you this day, as we pray in silence. For all these things, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, our needs, our prayers, we put before you this day, and we ask that you grant us a sense of your nearness, your comfort, your care for us, even in times when we are down and low and even sad. But also instill in us a sense of respect for and care for all of creation. We ask these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin, Blessed Josephine Vaquita, we humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
not to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with me, your unworthy servant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and your entire faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, be dear to say, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
again, for the benefit of those joining me virtually in the celebration of the Mass, make this act of spiritual communion insofar as you're unable to receive the Eucharist physically at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are really present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I hunger to receive you. Since I cannot receive communion at this moment, feed my soul, at least spiritually. I unite myself wholly to you now, as I do when I actually receive you. Permit me never to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed by partaking of this divine will, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of the Blessed Josephine Makita, bearing in our bodies the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you all once again for joining with me in this celebration of the Mass, though you've done so virtually. Let us all remember